Now let's cover the use of an AED on an infant for the healthcare professional for one rescuer. The scene has already been deemed safe, our gloves are on, our rescue mask with the one-way valve is available. But on top of that, because now we're looking at using an AED, we should be checking to make sure that the scene is AED safe as well, which means there are no combustible gases or liquids in the area and the baby is not lying in standing water or a puddle that connects them to us, as we don't want to become accidentally electrocuted. So if they're in a standing puddle of water, we would pick them up and move them safely to a drier area, dab them off enough that the actual electrodes would stick to their skin on their chest and back. Now we assess for responsiveness. Baby, are you all right? Are you okay? The baby does not respond, and so we activate EMS, call 911, or call a code. If we were sending somebody to go call 911, we might say, hey, you in the plaid shirt, go call 911 and come back. I might need your help. And bring an AED with you if you can find one. But in this case, we actually have an AED available, so we don't have to worry about that. I'm going to assess the baby for breathing, normal breathing, and I'm going to check for a pulse for no more than 10 seconds on the brachial artery. The baby does not have a pulse and the baby is not breathing normally. So because I have an AED here, I'm going to go ahead and use it immediately by turning it on.
Remove clothing from person's chest.
I strip the clothing down over the chest and back so that I can reveal the chest and back, dry it off if needed, and now it's prepared for the AED pads. It's prompted me to attach the electrodes. So I reach into the back and I grab the infant size electrodes. If I didn't have infant size electrodes, I can use adult size electrodes. But if there are infant pads available and it's an infant size patient, which is 1 year or younger, I'm going to use the infant pads. I now attach one of the pads to the front of the chest while I attach the second pad to the back of the baby. Now, remember, in a real baby, we're going to be rolling them to their side, attaching the pad, rolling them back, and making sure they're both firmly pressed onto their skin.
Check connector and pads.
Now I'm going to plug in my connector.
Analyzing rhythm. Everyone stand clear.
We're going to stand clear and not touch the patient.
Shock advised. Charging. Everyone stand clear. Everyone stand clear. Push the shock button.
I'm being prompted to push the flashing yellow button.
Shock delivered. Begin 5 cycles of CPR.
Now I go into my 30 compressions, followed by 2 rescue breaths. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. More compressions. I do this right over the AED pads. I will not remove the AED pads. 8, 9, 10, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, followed by 2 more rescue breaths. Stop touching the patient. Let the AED analyze.
Shock advised. Charging. Everyone stand clear. Everyone stand clear. Push the shock button. Shock delivered. Begin 5 cycles of CPR.
And I'm going to go right back into my CPR compressions, and I'm going to continue to do this until EMS arrives, the rest of the help comes, and we find definitive treatment for this infant, or until the baby starts to respond and breathe normally.